what they want to draft in this patch than Secret. And if that's how it goes, Alliance have a good chance to win the match. Mm. But if Puppy figures them out and actually outdrafts them, I just don't see Alliance winning against Secret with a weaker draft. I don't think they will.
I love watching S4 Puppy draft series.
Yeah.
Best of ones are their own animal in a lot of ways, because it's all about bringing your best game immediately. Whereas drafters like Puppy and S4, they really shine in these extended series where they can make a draft happen, learn from it, and then make adjustments. And so I'm really excited to see how the entire series goes, really, with their drafting.
And their lanes are looking really good right now with the Undying Nef, Undying and Lone Druid. They can even put those two in the offlane together to ensure that Lone Druid gets farmed.
But I will agree with your point, Scan.
Yeah, I mean, Alliance have been drafting really well. In fact, to be honest, all of the best periods in Alliance's career have involved them figuring out like a draft style they really like, and then just they draft themselves into a position where they can play their own style of Dota and win.
Right.
Yes. And so that's, I feel like if they get into that position here, they're actually favorites in this match. If they don't, troubles.
Yeah, when Alliance doesn't have to react to the other team's draft, they make the other team react to their draft, is when it's hard to deal with Alliance.
Now with Undying picked up on the side of Alliance, doesn't that feel like they have everything that they need to react to whatever Team Secret does, just place a tombstone and fight around it if they want? Or place a tombstone and run away? It's such a control of... It gives you the control fight. You can try to fight around the tombstone, you can try to run away from the tombstone, but at least it's there to make sure that either you fight or you have the space to run and disengage.
It's actually quite annoying as an Ember Spirits, I think, playing against an Undying if you get into a fight, because the slow stacks up on you and your remnants go a lot slower.
It's just for the lane, because Ember's weaker at the start and Undying can sort of limit his farm in the early first few waves. After that, Undying doesn't do too much against Ember when he has a few levels in the mid game. It's mostly to secure their lanes right now, the Undying.
Why do you think they picked the Bounty Hunter Winter? Because every game this tournament, I think, that I've seen a Bounty Hunter, it was in response to a Chen or an Enigma or something, and there's no jungler there for Alliance.
It's probably, maybe they feel like they needed a hero that can disrupt, because when you have Undying is a support that doesn't want to move. You go to one lane, it's like Lich, you go to one lane, and you want to keep winning the lane. And Bounty is different, it's like opposite, you go everywhere. You try to create chaos in the other lanes. So maybe they're thinking that, okay, Undying's not going to move, so we want a support that can actually move around and pressure the other two lanes, and maybe we'll sack one of our lanes, and then we are able to help their lanes.
Sorry, this is one of the first Rubiks that we see. Why do we see it here specifically? And the meanest thing in the entire tournament.
There's a few reasons. I mean, stealing track's nice, but also instant disable when you're trying to pick off an Ember Spirit, it's very useful. Ember Spirit can be very tricky to pick off.
He's still not the best support to lock down Ember.
But they actually, you know, it's Alliance picked the Rubik as well when they did the push strategy against EG yesterday. So
it's just a draft they want to get, though, it feels like. They don't really, it's not like they're reacting towards what the enemy has. Oh, they have this, so we want Rubik. It's like, we have something in mind that we want to support in the lane that has a disable, so we can win our lane.
Right.
And it's less of, oh, Rubik has a lot of spells to steal, so we are picking Rubik this game.
And it also fits naturally into the push, because of the null field. Which...
Yeah, the null field is very good for push, yeah. I agree.
And it's maybe one of the kind of themes that we see throughout the group stages as well, where Alliance is the team that comes with a plan, and maybe Secret is more reactive to other people's plans,
and
still searching
Agreed.
For their own kind of style and way.
Agreed.
Although, I mean, yeah, to some I agree with what Winter said about Undying triggering them picking the Bounty Hunter, but also to some extent I feel like maybe they came into the match wanting to go for it. Highlighter Bounty Hunter is like quite a classic. It's a way in which Secret have historically controlled the early game. So, I do still think they're mostly being reactive, but I think maybe that's one thing they were hoping to be able to get.
Yeah, because right now the style they're going to play is they're going to try and split up and try to move Alliance around. Alliance are very, very focused on putting all their heroes in one lane and running, pushing down a lane, because they have like Undying. You want to play around the Undying. You don't want to be moving around. So, what Secret is wanting to do right now is try to force them to rotate with the Prophet maybe, and then Bounty will be picking them off with track. That's like their best scenario to happen in the game.
Did we mention how cool that stage looks, by the way?
It's very nice.
It is very nice. Sorry.
And the Dazzle has really just been the big fallback hero for Puppy. When there's not a signature hero that's like really fantastic this patch, Dazzle he's so comfortable on the hero. So it's just something that they fall back on and they like a lot.
Yeah, Windranger removed from the pool. It's actually, Alliance considers that a good counter towards the bear for Lone Druid. Just shackle him. took him down.
And it was always what Secret did with the Ember. They wanted to go Ember and Windranger together for Eternal Envy and Weehaw. It's a combination they've always loved, so...
I think Alliance's draft is really just trying to make Weehaw as uncomfortable as possible. They've banned out... they banned out four of his best heroes. Like, Invoker's, I think, his best hero this patch, and they banned it out immediately, even over some of the other stereotypical Team Secret heroes. And now they pick a Slardar for Lota.
Yeah, because they need a safe laner that can actually move around. Like I mentioned, position one in the team is actually Bulldog when they have someone like Lone Druid. So Slardar is like off lane but play in their safe lane.
Slardar is actually good for so many reasons. It's a Lota hero, it's good at catching out the Nature's Prophets, the Ember Spritz, you can, you know, amp damage him.
Ember's very weak.
Bounty answer.
Very weak, what's his stat?
And even the Dazzle Weave, so it's actually a perfect pick there for Alliance, in my opinion.
Yeah, I think it's great. And you said something about when Bulldog's playing Lone Druid, he's kind of the one position for Alliance, and that has definitely been the trend for Alliance so far. I mean, Bulldog has the fourth highest GPM of any player at this event, period. And he's averaging more than 100 more than both S4 and Lota, so they're really putting a lot of their eggs into Bulldog farming up as fast as possible.
I think they were doing a wave and we missed it. Damn it.
Anyone got a guess for the last pick for Team Secret?
They need a mid that doesn't take up too much farm, like might spit push. Oh, that's the mid, I guess.
Gyrocopter? Oh, that's not us!
I'm just trying to show off.
That's really interesting because...
Are they going to run gyro mid? Do you know if they run gyro mid?
I know Wings did gyro mid.
We've seen it yesterday.
Complexity runs gyro mid too.
I wonder what do the viewers need to look out for this match?
I think that the Radiance timing on the Lone Druid will set the pace on them, because once they get the Radiance, they're just going to 5-man and push on as much tower.
And you favor Alliance for this draft?
Yeah, I think the draft is much easier to execute.
Okay, let's find out if that bear is going to get as much farm as he wants. It is time for the first game of Alliance taking on Team Secret. Let's go, Eldian Gods.
We are live here on the floor of Minsk Arena, Gods. It's a big match. Team Secret versus Alliance, best of three. Winner moves on to face Team Liquid tomorrow. A lot at stake in this game. Alliance has really seen a resurgence in this patch. Misery had a cheeky tweet about them a couple of weeks ago that all of Alliance's heroes got buffed. They've been playing pretty much all of them. What are your thoughts on the draft? We got a countdown. All right, go. Well, Alliance have gone for the Alliance strat. They're going to keep picking their heroes and keep picking them until they stop working. For Secret, I think the panel's kind of spot on. They're kind of reactionary to what other teams are doing, but less than not having a style of their own, their style is that they react. And I think they've made a plan for Alliance. They intentionally left the Prophet and Bear in the pool, happy to take the Nature's Prophet. And I think they come into this match very much with a set plan in mind to disrupt Alliance. All right, we get underway now. We might be in the heart of CIS, but you would not know it. There are a ton of Alliance fans here. Even at the hotel when we got back last night, they mobbed Bulldog as he got off the bus. So it is a very hyped up crowd. Pilei Dai on the Bounty Hunter. Going to get things underway, scouting out the Alliance heroes off in their own jungle. Moving around as a pack of four. Looks like they want to secure that bottom rune. The runes will be spawning in about 18 seconds. Meanwhile, Bulldog with the bear trying to figure out what the lanes are for Secret early on, but not getting any intel just yet.
They know Envy is playing the gyrocopter, so that means it will be a wee mid Ember Spirit, much to, I think, most people's surprise.
And this goes to the bans. They banned four of Weehaw's heroes. I guess they didn't see anything else they liked, so they're going to try to show their flexibility here. But otherwise, it's always been Envy on the Ember Spirit.
Well, happy to send it mid. It is a hero that can do pretty well against Puck in lane, just Puck unable to really bully an Ember Spirit out. So I think this is something in the past when Ember was run more as a mid, was done so because it could lane just fine against the Puck.
Only time I saw this matchup this tournament, it was Sumail on the Ember mid. He got a solo kill on Dendi at about 3 minutes into the game. So it is a matchup where Ember has some kill potential. We'll see S4 trying to punish him early and keep him on the defensive.
Yeah, and Pilei Dai, very much the X factor as far as the first 5 minutes of the game go. He's going to be the one who can roam around, create problems, be it for the Puck, go for the courier snipes. In this case, he's just securing some early game farm for Misery by harassing the Rubick as much as possible. And this is something they don't really have good answers to.
Yeah, they do have a Hill Ward there in the mid lane to try and protect the bottom. It's Misery taking a lot of damage, looking to turn this. They are going to deploy a Dust here. Nice and early, the Crush just clipping Pi. He could be in trouble. This may well be first blood for the Alliance. It is! You would think we're in Sweden from the way this crowd gets amped up for that.
As for diving pretty far here in the mid lane. Okay, also rotating in. So it's the flame guard, but it's only level one, can be fairly easily broken. And S4 really going to commit here now. The flame, the phase shift, and Weeha won't be forced to use that flame guard, able to just back away. But it does force the pie rotation, so they know where the bounty hunter is for the moment. So far, Alliance, they're the team that's looking to apply pressure.
Yeah, well, I guess the pressure in response to Secret's aggressive lanes. They say, you want to get aggressive with us? We're not going to let that happen. And Pi already on the move, doing his job to kind of harass S4, who's still got a salve and shouldn't have any problems as far as dealing with Bounty Hunter for now.
Now, the one lane we haven't really looked at all is that Lone Druid top Bulldog in the off lane against the Gyrocopter and Nature's Prophet dropping pretty quickly here. Looks like he may end up going down. He will. Loda and EGM combining. Looks like a lift into a crush and then just follow-up damage. So well played by Alliance, getting another kill. They're really punishing this offlane Prophet.
And that was the lane that Secret committed the Bounty Hunter to at the start, and very much to doing so, they were saying, we want this lane to go well for us and to win it. And it's completely backfired. Just through sheer misplays, they've been put in a bad position.
As for diving for this one, onto Weeha, there's the salve as he goes uphill, and he will not be able to get the kill, but does cancel the salve. Unfortunately for S4, a regen rune is waiting, so it's as though it never happened.
Yep.
Also on Dying, camping out mid again. They're really putting a lot of pressure on this mid and bottom lane. Bulldog on an island, but God, so far, it seems to be paying off. He's still 8-4, getting just as much as the Prophet without the help.
Yeah, the Ember just having a really rough time mid because of the Undying who's been camping out, and just 6 CS on Wii's Ember Spirit is something to really kind of concern yourself with for Team Secret.
Three hero rotation, even Pi coming in, looking for that bear, but Bulldog is going to retreat himself back to the big camp. Just do a bit of jungling while the lane's pushed out. Definitely feels like a nice boon to the Lone Druid in this patch, just having that option to go to the jungle from the offlane much easier and more quickly at this stage.
Seems Bounty Hunter very aware, though. He's already rotating in.
Oh, can he steal it? Ah, too late for Pi.
And that's something Bulldog should be keeping tabs on, and knowing that the Bounty Hunter's now kind of sitting right here with him.
And they have a sentry mid, so they know he's not mid, or if he is, he's at least not a threat. And in fact, he's going to drop a sentry. I believe that does block the camp. So trying to slow down the Lone Druid's farm progression. Yep. Weeha and Ake trading blows. Zombie on Ember action. Seems the Samurai for now, not having the best time of it. But this mid lane, how concerned are you if you're Secret? Weeha, Ember, 7-2. Historically, when Secret have run Ember, it's even with like a Magnus or Slardar in their team, and Envy gets free farm in the safe lane, but this is not that kind of Ember.
I almost want to say they should be incredibly concerned. This is one of their big tempo controllers. As far as initiation goes, Ember Spirit is it at most stages of the game. Like, his level 6, getting the Fire Remnants coming to play, he's the one here who can rotate to other lanes, set up kills, and allow the Gyrocopter. Like, Gyrocopter can't just expect to TP to the offlane, TP mid, and get a cooldown Rocket Barrage.
Unless they're tower diving, they're not going to be able to find him.
So, I think Ember doing well and not being forced to be put in a position where he just feels like he needs to farm and catch up is kind of the key to Secret's draft here, but that's exactly what's not happened to them. So I think Alliance very comfortable here in the early stages.
Yeah, he is getting his levels. That's the good news for Weeha, and perhaps we'll see them switch up the lanes at some point down the road. But for now, it is just Weeha mid. Hasted Zombie doing laps around the lane, was looking for the courier, not able to find it. Sanki will back off, and we're going to see the Bounty Hunter now make his rotation to the bottom lane. He has really been all around the world, but as we've often seen with Pai Lai Dai, he doesn't always get a lot done in the laning stage. Teams are very accustomed to playing against this Bounty Hunter, but that mid game is where he so often opens the map up, gets a deep ward, maybe he just finds one kill with the Gyrocopter. This game could be a possibility, and then they can start to take over. But to date, he has been very quiet.
I think a nice move to just ditch this bottom lane completely as far as not sending the Prophet down here. Anyone who goes down here is just going to get taken out, and Pi makes a nice move to draw aggro off the tower, prevent it taking a bit of extra damage, and making sure he still gets the farm and XP from the creep wave.
And the tower takes a bit of chip damage. Both lineups with their push potential, whether it's the Lone Druid or the Nature's Prophet, there is quite a bit of tower demolishing ability on either side. There's Misery back in the jungle now, has the face boots picked up, it closes in on his level 6. Gotta imagine once he gets that Nature's Wrath that Secret will be looking for a potential pickoff here.
Yep.
Oh, Dust, but Pi on the low ground, so the economic damage is applied, slowing Secret down a little bit. Or Alliance, rather. Overall thoughts in the laning stage, you said Alliance is very comfortable. At what point do they look for more than just the static farming phase?
I think they're fine with it for now. They'll take like a tower push where possible, but I think the next kind of big move for Alliance is just hitting that blink dagger timing on Slada. Like, he gets a blink and then he's ready and happy to rotate and start creating space for Bulldog, because Bulldog is pretty much the one position player. He's the one position player in this game who's not going to get the farm for the first 10 minutes of the game. But when Slider is blink, when Puck is levels, and then you transition to Puck getting blink because of the ganks that the Slider creates, and then the entire time this is happening, Bulldog's farming, he's getting his Midas, he's getting Radiance, and then you get to the mid-game point where suddenly Bear is actually the most farmed here in the game. He may be currently on 1700 net worth, but if everything goes according to plan for Alliance, that will not remain the case.
Weeha with a rather ineffective attempt to harass Aki mid lane. Very durable, the Undying. And they have deployed a Sentry bottom, but it got quickly eaten by Pylai Dai, so he's been on top of things, trying to prevent Alliance from knowing his whereabouts. A secondary Sentry comes out. It's going to be D-Ward Wars, and Pi again the victor. Cheeky little yellow goblin.
Oh, they're diving him, but they got the amp, but...
Now, that's going to put an end to the shenanigans, at least for now. Is that Sentry in range of the Observer? He may even try to sneak back in for it.
Just
out of range. So that is rather fortunate for Alliance. Very annoying, this Bounty Hunter.
This Ember, still 16 CS only. He has less CS than the Lone Druid in the offlane. He's getting almost doubled. He's getting more than doubled up upon by the Puck, almost triple the CS on the Puck. So this is absolutely
again,
disastrous.
they don't have the Magnus, which they were running a lot with Envy's Ember back in the previous version. So they don't have the farm accelerant. Are they stacking for him, I guess, would be the next question. I don't think so with the Prophet.
Not particularly. And
so it is going to be all about the ganks then.
It kind of has to be at this stage, I think, just because of like how the Ember Gyro will work together. And the only way for Ember to catch up, I think, is going to be through actually going for ganks more so than it is going to be going for our farm. So Ember now, level 7, probably wants like maybe another level or two just to get like that value point in Slider Fist, alternatively get that fourth point in Flame Guard, but I don't think this is a game where Weeha can just sit back and say, okay, I'm getting owned in CS, let's just try and farm my way back in this game. That's just going to work against him. Like, Slider's just going to... You want to go aggressive before Slider goes aggressive on you, because if you ever get blink crushed as Weeha, you're dying.
Yeah, and these secret heroes are all very frail. Maybe the gyro builds tanky, but nobody is naturally so, and that's where the blink dagger could cause a lot of problems. Was about to be completed, load ahead on 1700, 1800 gold last time we took a look, and now eclipsing 2000. Zeroing in on it. Looking for that first move from Alliance. That's probably where they do rotate the Lone Druid. But mid lane, Secret are going to make their move onto Aki. Force out the Tombstone and then look to turn. The zombie's going to work. S4 ready to go and will bring him down now. Weeha could be next. Where's the backup? Has the Remnant. But gets bashed. Oh no. Load on the chase. Might be able to find the Ember. Just one last Remnant. And the tower's going to turn with the Nature's Wrath. They get the counter kill. Beautifully played by Secret. That was a profit buyback though. It's an early buyback, so will definitely be worth it, but not a free kill.
Yeah,
it
wouldn't have cost him much. Did Loda buy his Blink Dagger before he went down?
No. He did not.
I wonder if he had money for it, too, because he TP'd in before he bought it. That's such a really smart play from Loda, where he's like, okay, I'm 2.1k gold, I'm so close to Blink. Most players there in the safe Blink slider would just be like, I'm going to finish my Blink, guys, you guys are on your own, but he just TP's in, says, look, I'll get this kill, make sure this goes right, and then from there I can transition my Blink Dagger. But unfortunately, a profit buyback with Wrath of Nature takes him down, and that's just one of those kind of freak things you just don't really expect when going for that dive.
Yeah, and he was pretty close to getting the Ember. If they got one more bash, that would have been a kill. So, rolled the dice, didn't pay off.
And even just Ember having the mana to use, like, a second Flame Remnant to escape. Like, he uses Flame Guard, Searing Chains to initiate, then had two Fire Remnant mana. That's pretty kind of uncommon this early on in the game.
Well, EGM definitely getting his levels on the Rubick. Already about to hit 7 at only 10 minutes in. Kind of brings to mind the old Alliance from the TI3 days where he would just get insane farm and levels in the jungle. Now Alliance gonna smoke. The Loda Blink Dagger, still not quite ready, I believe. And they're gonna move.
He just got it.
Just picked it up. All right. This is the time to strike. But where's the vision? They have the one ward down bottom lane, but three heroes off the map. Alliance likely suspecting that Secret clustering up here.
Looks like they're gonna drop a ward here, and yeah, they get vision of everything going on in this bottom lane.
Maybe they look to go on mid instead, but with the two wards, like you said, perhaps they're confident. Secret don't know there's a lane ward, as that sentry was just out of range, so there may be an opportunity to find a pick.
Alliance is just so set on making this gank work. They're just gonna sit here, hiding in the Roche Pit for as long as possible until loaded TP's top. Problem is, there's an observer ward there to scout out this rotation, so this is not exactly something that's gonna go unseen. Secret, see load up. He also know he just TP'd, so if they want to go to aggressive bottom, it's a really good opportunity for them to do so.
They could make a move perhaps on S4. Yeah, in fact, smoke. It's their turn to smoke. Secret looking to strike back. S4 also closing down his blink up to 1500 gold. A kill at this time would be big. And Pi stalks him through the jungle out in front of the fairy dragon. And meanwhile, Alliance with three mids, so he does group up with the team. It looks like in the end they won't find the pick. But they dodged the bullet of that first Blink Dagger gank, and now it has been revealed.
Yeah, and S4 playing that one really safe. A lot of pucks there would have stopped off to farm like a jungle camp or something. He's just like, nope, I'm just going to join up for the 5-man with my team, or the 4-man, while Lone Druid gets his farm up top. And
they're going to start this one off with a Weave. Weeha, not ready to jump in though. Need to put the defensive remnant. Moving forward towards the puck, but the silence is there from S4, and he's gonna jaunt away.
Yep.
At the bottom rune, looks like there's also a bit of a skirmish. Loda able to grab the bounty. Finally die again. Almost level 6 here has been a pest, to put it mildly. And you could see the results of the supports.
Yeah.
They're both quite poor right now.
So far a very manageable pest, and that's the big question is, does that change when he gets level 6, gets track online? And we haven't actually seen Envy leave the safe lane as far as farming on Gyrocopter. And I think a big part of that is he realizes the lane situation is going poorly, wants to make sure he's maintaining his farm, and rotating for like one kill in a four-man situation isn't going to be worth his time or like justifiable as far as the return you get until they have track money. So once Bounty hits level 6, more likely we see Envy go for some rotations.
Well, he grabs it now. Pyli die. Does have access to the ultimate, and at the same time, Alliance about to get the puck blink, so they're going to have double blink. And I wonder if that's where Alliance really doubled down on the aggression. There is an observer ward in the jungle. So they may see this one fly out.
I think the other big reason Envy's happy to sit farming top is because he's so safe. Often you just stay in the safe lane farming for days, you're going to get ganked, but with that tier 1 tower ward, you just see any rotation coming your way. Again, he's going to see EGM sitting behind Admiral Bulldog and just know exactly what's going on up here.
Oh, the bear almost sniped by a heal bomb. Bulldog will go for the resummon. Doesn't want to be feeding 300 gold away. And that's double blink.
Okay.
Very quiet game considering the heroes. We've got a Puck, a Slardar, a Gyrocopter, an Ember.
You see,
we want Blood Gods.
Yes, he's
where
stuck
is it?
An 11-minute blink LD. Isn't that meant to be when the kills happen? Come on, let's go, Alliance.
We want blood. We want violence, guts, and gore. Alliance, you need to provide it. But Secret are happy to play their own farm game at this stage.
These Swedes are just too nice and gentle. That's the problem. They need to.
Maybe out of game. In game, they're stone cold killers.
Well, they need to show it, right?
And not just in Dota, we've seen it at CSGO as well. Oh, S4 blinking back. The whole team, frantic retreat. They did see the rotation coming in. And it looks like still no kills.
Another TP, and another TP perhaps spotted. Loda actually hiding in the trees for now. May have been just out of sight with that TP in, so really nice warding from Secret. And you look at this game and you see like a 10-minute slider blink, a 30-minute puck blink, and not a single kill from these two items. That's entirely attributed to the warding as well as Bounty Hunter's just scouting that he's provided. So Secret's done an amazing job preventing Alliance from finding pickoffs right now.
On the flip side for Alliance, they are farming their lone druid uncontested, and he went for the Midas first. The Radiance is coming soon, at least the Relic, not too far.
Alliance is still happy with the pace of this game, even if they're not finding the kills they'd like with the blink daggers that they've got. So again,
we're moving out, and now they finally make a committed jump onto the top lane, but Loda, quick with the crush, gets the amp off. And we're gonna calm down for a little bit there. As for the bottom lane, though, Pyli died clipped by the orb, silenced up, Grave, and surviving for now. Puck's forced to blink away. The Prophet was thinking about joining the skirmish. And now it's Lotus turn. All right, that's also a swing and a miss.
I mean, again, it's Pyli Dai with scouting information that's giving Secret the opportunity to try and take those kind of kills. They initiate up top because Pi scouts two heroes bottom. He also cancels the puck's TP up there with the dagger. So as a result, Alliance didn't have the hero to rotate on the S4 puck, but at the same time, Secret just didn't also have the killing potential at top. The Ember alone needed the Gyrocopter cooldown Rocket Barrage to follow it up. But
so overall strategy for Secret Gods, it looks like Secret want to play the economy game. There's a Midas of Misery, I believe a Dominator up on the Gyrocopter of Envy, who has been beginning to stack Ancients.
They want to split the map and just and farm. They want to do this classic secret thing where they've got a draft which has no way to team fight. Shouldn't really be winning at this stage of the game, or really any stage of the game with a bad start, but they're just going to be annoying, like creep-skipping waves, farming wherever Alliance are not, and Alliance is going to keep trying to find these kills, and Pylodai is just going to keep on denying it to them, so...
So, at what point, if you're Alliance, do you say, we just have to bite the bullet and go for a gem? Is it going to come down to that pesky Ancient?
Oh, absolutely. That sounds like
not cooperating.
I think that's something they want to get in the next 3 to 4 minutes, if possible. Like, there's no real reason not to even buy it now on someone like Puck or Slaughter. They've got the items they need. They have the ability to control team fights. There's obviously the big risk of losing it, but I don't see any way Alliance lose a 5v5 engagement right now.
Yeah, they've got the Tomb as well. We haven't really talked much about the Undying, but it just adds a huge component to these team fights. It's level 3 now, so it starts to get pretty scary. He's prioritizing the Soul Rip over the Decay, and we're going to see Secret moving down towards bottom. They're smoked. There is a Radiant Observer Ward here, so it might well see them right as the smoke breaks. In time for a retreat, Aki, the man in front. And it is going to be a reveal. Now the track and the double blink away. See you later, Ake. Good luck, buddy. We wish you all the best. And it looks like Ake will just walk out of there. But they're committing with the Ember. They're really diving for this Undying. Dangerous hero to focus on. They get the track off. The heal comes out. Tombstone was deployed. And the Shuriken brings him down. Oh, it's for the mid lane. Cooldown also thrown out. Secret finding their first track kill of the game here. And also defending mid.
Yeah, that was like a full-on ditch there. Alliance, actually, I don't think they quite realized that Secret weren't in the best fighting shape. They didn't have their entire team, but you see like a hero pop out of smoke like that, and you're just thinking, oh, we have two heroes mid, let's just ditch. And for Secret getting their first track kill of the game, a nice little boost to their economy.
Wondering if EGM's going to be able to get his hands on the track. For now, it is a level 4 Shadow Wave. Could be completely fight-changing, and, you know, with the amp damage, that thing packs a punch, yeah. So... Definitely something to keep your eyes on.
No surprise, Bulldog topping the net worth. It didn't take him long to go from middle of the pack to top of the pack. And
how good of a lone druid game do you think it is? Obviously, he's had a great start. Is this a game where the bear can just basically put the entire Alliance squad on its back and just carry them to victory? Or is he going to be much more reliant on the team to take over?
Yeah, they don't really have any good heroes to deal with the Spirit Bear, I feel. Like, you can try and boost up your team a little bit by using Weave and try and control it with the Searing Chain some, but I think all in all, the Spirit Bear is going to be really powerful and strong and great at dealing with some of the squishy heroes like Dazzle, like Bounty Hunter, making it impossible for them to fight. For Secret, like, team fighting into a Radiant Spirit Bear is going to get very, very tricky, so...
I guess it's going to come down to that. Alliance still looking for their first kill with these Blink Daggers. It's been awful quiet.
That's got to be close to unheard of, getting two Blinks this early on when you've got a 2k gold lead and not finding any kills.
I think at this point, thus far, Pylodai MVP, just for the ward game alone.
Yep, I totally agree. He is... salvage this poor laning stage that Secret had through his play, and suddenly we're looking at a level 7 Bounty Hunter, and a kind of scary thought for Alliance is that they could be giving up track money to a Secret team who could start to snowball off of that.
Another ward. He got one down on the high ground.
Yep.
Pylodai continues to be a complete pest in the woods. Not finding the kills too often, but giving them the map control they need on the top lane, S4. Misery is going to move towards him. Don't think they have too much kill potential, and he's just going to blink away. So again, Alliance just waiting for the bear to come online. Secret farming the map, spreading as much as possible, and keeping it a low-kill game. Or quiet game. 500 gold advantage at 19 minutes. I don't think I've ever seen that few dots at the bottom of the net worth chart at this
Man,
stage.
Man, these guys, you're in Belarus. You're meant to be playing some CIS Dota. The crowd's falling asleep here, LD.
Well, they heard the crowd. They're like, we've already pleased them. We can just chill now. They're cheering for Bulldog yawning in the booth.
I love that when they just show Bulldog and he's like, not even.
Yeah, my work's done here. Say Alliance, and I imagine Secret feeling similarly. Yep. We can just relax and farm creeps.
They showed up. That was the hard part for Alliance for this tournament. Now
that was the real test.
Now that they're here, it's like, oh, okay, we'll play some Dota later.
Oh, it is top lane where they try to catch out S4 here in the trees, but he's able to orb Jaunt away. Don't know if the Ember's going to be able to catch him, and if he does jump in, it could end really poorly. While that was happening, I think EGM knows there's a ward in the neighborhood, and he is going to get the D ward here. As they go back in on top, there's a blink forward, crush, but Weehaw able to dodge it. Looks like he jaunts it away just in the nick of time, and a good thing he did, or he may have dropped there.
The bear has Radiance, by the way. This is a really fast timing for Bulldog.
Uncontested, Midas Radiance, 20 minutes in the offlane, mind you, with basically no help. They did gank his, well, pressure his lane, but they didn't find any kills, and he was dealing with a duel and even tri-lane for quite a bit, and now it is Deathfall around the bear, or at least group up around it for Alliance. Three top, looking to take towers in the mid lane also. EGM, gonna find another one perhaps. There's the blinking from S4, clearing out the wave. Glyph was committed, and the tower gonna drop, so Alliance, a quick double grab. Dramatically accelerating the team's net worth with that. Two towers, both last tip.
I think it's one of the big things about Alliance's drop is there's no real one timing where it's like, okay, they got their two blink daggers. In theory, it's like they won a fight. That's a good timing for them. But also, like, 3 or 4 minutes later, like, okay, we've now got, like, a few more items. Like, it's also good timing for them. Then later, they get the Bear Radiance. Like, right now, it's like, okay, Bear Radiance. It's good timing, right, to go fight. But Alliance don't need to fight at any stage. They're not worried about Secret's drop, like, overlapping them later on when they get powerful or come online. For them, it's very much, as long as we're not giving away kills, giving them track money, playing like a slow, steady game, Secret are going to be in trouble.
And if it does go much later, you've always got the puck to build a Hex to deal with even a very farmed Ember, and
yep,
he went for a Blink Dagger, so our Ember Spirit is not going to get particularly farmed. Smoke finally picked up. Looks like Secret might want to make a move, but they're fighting into the full complement of Alliance heroes, should they choose to do so, as Alfredo gets to work here on the Tier 2. Throwing everything at him, even the homing missile, just giving him a dunk in the head.
Puppy.
But Loda threatening to go in. Looks like they do have ice armor to try and slow down the physical damage the Alliance can bring to bear. And there's a quick roar to push back the gyrocopter, so they'll reset with the bear. Slow and steady split push from the Nature's Prophet while this is happening, always ready to join the fight.
I mean, the one thing they do kind of need to push around is the bear cooldown, as well as having a healthy bear. Like, the when the Spirit Bear gets down to like a couple hundred HP, it does get a lot trickier to maintain your push.
And if you resummon it and then you die, you're in a lot of trouble.
Yeah, he resummons it now, so Alliance won't want to take a risky fight with just the one bear, but they know they're in a comfortable position to get this Tier 2. But again, Secret, they find a trade. They take the Tier 2 bottom, Misery, continuing to be really annoying himself, and he's got 2.7k gold. It really feels like this is just going to be an Aghanim Scepter game for him. You're not fighting, you're turning it's turned into kind of a split push game. You know Alliance is going to have that scary five man around like a lone druid AC that can push and break really fast. I think Aghanim Scepter just is like the item this game for NP. It's the item in any game these days, so this game no different.
Well, this is turning into a Who's the Rat King contest pretty quickly.
Well,
last time we saw a team try to out-rat Alliance was EG in the group stage, and we all know how that went.
Look, if there's anyone who can out-rat Alliance, I would say it's probably Eternal Envy. As far as maybe it's like less ratty, but it's very much those like cheeky little plays he makes where he's like creeping waves and stuff. Normally it's on the Ember Spirit, but he's one of the people like I would say could maybe do it.
As long as he buys the TP.
Hey man, you're ratting.
He's a new man. In fairness to Jackie Mao, he's come a long way under the guidance of Puppy. And they are going to find someone at long last. Pi gets crushed, but where's the detection? Do they have anything for him? There's the amp. And with that, Pi's going to drop. Nice pick there.
Was that a gem on Puck, or is that just
I think they do have
one. Yeah, they just got the gem.
So, something we were talking about earlier, and with the Yule Scepter grab, feels a lot safer to carry the gem now. This could really shut down Secret split push game.
You're effectively invulnerable with this Puck Yules, unless you play go aggressive, so, well, which may happen, but theoretically, if you play cautiously, which this game is being a game of caution, you're not going to go down with the gem.
Well, Alliance are feeling very strong right now. Lotus BKB flying out on the courier. And with that, the Yules on the Puck, the continuous farm piling in for Bulldog. They are going to look for a Roshan attempt. They've got the ward up on the high ground. Alliance, no. If Secret try to walk in, short of a smoke, this is not going to be easy. It looks like they may be wanting to contest here. Nature's Prophet has the TP. The smoke is committed, and down the ramp they're about to go. Secret are coming in. Call down snare. It may connect on three, but S4 with a quick jump. He is the gem carrier. Has to be careful through this load of Puppy, the BKB. But do they find a kill yet? Puppy stays alive through it. All the bears been slain. Alfredo down for the count. Another crush coming in, and there's the resummon. Bulldog re-engaging on the back lines of the fight. The puck is falling to Rubik too. So far, a perfect engagement, but heroes start to get low. Loda also in danger. Can they finish off Misery? The Shuriken's gonna bounce! Is it enough?
I think he blink dodged it.
He blink dodged the Shuriken on the Sardar and barely survives. It's a pair on a Prophet.
What a grave.
But they're turning this. We are moving forward. Secret taking the fight. Hockey in danger. Bulldog might go down here. Needs a rune. Needs a rune. He's not gonna get it. Oh, the chains. The pain now for Alliance. They felt so strong.
Not a hit.
But they were wrong.
Not a hit.
And the grave again from Puppy. 4-6. A wipeout at the pit. and Secret in command of this game now.
That was a gem swing as well. Every Secret just played that team fight so well. Every hero is like getting away on 1 HP. Misery gets the grave TP out. They take out the bear really fast. I think a lot of teams in that situation are just going to ignore the spirit bear and just go for the heroes, but Secret say, no, let's make sure we take out the spirit bear right away at the start of the fight, because that's like the one unit closest to us that's doing a lot of damage, and then it just made the fight a lot easier for them, and all in all, an incredible team fight execution coming out of Team Secret.
Feels like they need to get the Dazzle first. Puppy did so much work in that fight. And he's got a bit booster, so that's a tanky Dazzle.
Like two massive graves off in that fight. The Weave made a huge difference as well, considering how much physical damage comes out of Alliance with the Lone Druid and the Slaughter. And
you lose that fight as Secret, you might just be losing Rax at that point. Like, most likely Alliance are getting the Aegis if they win that fight. You're denied all the track gold. You only have two tier 2s.
Really? I mean, and, right away, but the game turns into that transitional point where Alliance can just go objective to objective. They have Roche control. They have like a 10k lead, and they just win the game off of it. But
we're gonna instead, see. The graph plummets a 7,500 gold swing nearly, and a big tide turner. And I think even bigger than the kills is possibly, as you mentioned, the gem pickup.
Oh, pie. Don't leave that gem there too long.
No littering. Come on. Trying to keep it clean here in Minsk. Five heroes moving top for Alliance. It seems like they are still looking for a fight here, despite the lost Roshan engagement. Bulldog's gonna morph. And they camp out on the high ground. This is the one they're looking for, but Puppy always close behind him. Even if they get the jump there, likely not gonna go down.
Great map awareness from Wii, just knowing that they're gonna be nearby. And
Secret know that that's what Alliance want. They want to try and find a pick with the double blink, and even if he did catch him, it would always be that grave. So Alliance keep it going mid. Tracks fly out, can only purge those ever so often. Top lane even looking for Envy, but he's the Aegis carrier, very tanky. I don't even think they can kill him, but they may try for it. They lift him, they toss him back, and now Weeha's moving forward on As4. Might go down here. Yule Scepter still cooling down from the earlier track. Purgy gets off the coil, the Sansa's Lair. There's the Yule's crush on two, but then coming in, the turn from Envy, looking for some damage from the cooldown. It's a decent one, and they managed to gun down the Slardar, killing off the Tombs on the Undying Droppy as well. Puck in a headlong retreat. Everything going Secret's way, and even hunting the bear now as the Rubick also falls elsewhere. EGM getting picked off. It's bear down. RS4 going back in. He will get the Dazzle, but is it worth it? Chants away, trying to survive. Weeha's got the angle. He finds him. That's four down all day. Secret again wiping the floor with the Alliance. And they didn't even come close to that Aegis.
Yep, 3k gold swing, track money as well going Secret's way. That was just a bit of a reckless jump coming up from Alliance. They just felt like they're getting a bit impatient here. They had such a good early game start. They were controlling the map, out farming Secret, and then suddenly the one bad Roshan fight, which I think was just Secret's great play more than any Alliance misplay, leads into Alliance just getting kind of on tilt here, it feels, and taking a very reckless fight.
I believe there's a butterfly coming right now for Envy, but the siege begins in earnest. Homie missile onto the bear.
That's his only bear.
And Bulldog might have just thrown his baby away. Right. They're going to chain it. Weeha committing for this. They really want to kill it off. They know how much it means. The Aegis will pop. Gyrocopter rather far up. His big item about to arrive in the midst of this fight. Butterfly now online. They scoot him away, dodging the Lotus Stun. And Secret will calmly back out.
If they kill that bear there, they may have actually been able to take Rax there, but the full staff getting it out of that second Sprout. And Alliance will
and
hold
now,
for now.
And now, a lot, Secret of all the options, Scott. They can play the rat game, they can go for fights, they may well win those fights. It seems like they're just outlasting Alliance head up, you know, straight up, and they have all the options, whereas Alliance feel very limited, caged in. The aggressive wards also got dropped during that push. So Secret, great map control here. It's going to be very tough for Alliance to break out of this contain.
And Envy's just getting so massive now. Hasn't gone for a BKB, and instead a butterfly giving him more just farm acceleration, as well as a great ability to fight into the Slaughter, as well as Lone Druid.
And butterfly really potent here against Slaughter and even the Lone Druid. So, like you said, very difficult to bring down. May force out the MKB grab. But the bear is just not feeling that durable.
Yeah.
It's really been struggling this game.
it's really kind of hard to get the MKB build up when you need like at least the AC minimum before that. And if you go like AC MKB, you're kind of like a very squishy glass cannon like Bear.
S4 found one, but is the backup coming in time? Yes, it is. Slardar there with the crush, then the bash follow up. Weeha still engaging out of this. He wants S4. He's going to jump into the middle of the BKB committed. Kill Puck able to get away. S4 showing off those Houdini skills now on the run. The track's there, Lota though. The flat cannon from Envy combined with the slate of this. Weeha snipes him on the retreat. It's a one for one there, but again, Bounty Hunter getting in the picture. Still, all things considered, because of the deficit, it looks like it's a very slight win for Alliance. But at this point, Profit can easily keep up and stay relevant now.
And Secret may also get the top tier 2 tower if they want to really try and push their luck here, but perhaps not the time and place to go for it. They're going to lurk around here, look for some pickoffs, try and also just make sure there's no Alliance ward scouting them out as well.
You say no, but they say yes. Onto S4, they're going to go. He's already jumped in. Can he make it out of here? Trying with the phase shift, blinks away, but the call down chases him, gets forced out, and then manages to drop the Yules. Now an orb. Ake instead will be the sacrificial lamb, and then a track onto EGM. Alliance being overrun, 13-6. But my god, it feels a lot worse than that.
That cooldown is just so well placed, because he knows that's exactly where S4 is going to be joining to, so he just like preemptively cooldowns it.
He almost hit him with it, and in the end, it keeps everyone away.
The full stuff from Rubik saves the S4 puck, but then suddenly Rubik's like, oh, I just saved you, and
now I'm going down with the ship.
Yeah, now I'm going down. I've got no escape. I'm suddenly in a bad position, and my full stuff's on cooldown, so.
And they'll break the base again here, up through the north end. Secret on the offense, Alliance. Contained, hanging back at the tier 3 tower. They brush forward with Lota, now a blink, sprinting as well. This is a long way to dive, and Secret may decide to turn on the Amp Puppy. Still committing, chains are there, we'll catch out Lota as well as the Baron to a heck of a lot of damage. And they're going the other way. Alright, Alliance, get back in there! How dare you leave your base! That Deschains will find the Bear again. Bulldog could be in trouble. The call down coming through. There's the Savage Roar. He gets scooted away, but Misery's jumped on top of him. In the middle of the Bears, he's being mauled. He needs help. The Self Sprout to keep him alive. Ember jumping here and there, back and forth. The crush comes through from Lota, but there's a grave again for Puppy. Keeping him alive. It's a triple for Envy. He's rushing after Ake. He wants him too. Undying down. It's an ultra. An easy one at that. Alliance still feeling invulnerable, and they are going now for a lane of Rax with so much late game available, even committing onto Lota here. This could be the fifth kill of the fight. Puck desperately trying to keep him alive. S4 bailing out his buddy, but still comes at the cost of a melee Rax, possibly more. Ranged will drop. We'll see if Secret are content with their bounty or if they even look to rotate on mid. Weeha, he wants more. They've got the track going on S4.
And
they're going to chase him.
Still dead for 20, and even when he respawns, he's just got the one bear. So in Secret's mind, it's like, okay, one, we can safely push the second Rax. Two, we can take the fight afterwards. We kill the bear once, and suddenly, that's Radiance out of the picture.
And who cares about the bear? It's hardly doing anything in these fights, it seems, at this point. S4 blinking in with the silence, but Envy almost guns him down as he comes out of the phase shift there, barely able to escape. Suddenly a Scotty complete, as though the little bugger wasn't already tanky enough. Secret now are happy. They've taken two full lanes. And what was once a systematic game for Alliance, it felt like the bread and butter. Lone Druid gets free farm, they get their double blinks, the Slardar BKB comes out, walk in, secure the Roche, and then push for the tier 3s. It's completely flipped on its head.
Yeah. It's approaching that just unwinnable state of the game. You look at someone like Lota, who always just plays that Specs Creator, and they have pulled him on Lone Druid, and his farm at this stage is just incomparable to any of the Secret heroes. He's not coming back. He's on par with the Dazzle, the Bounty Hunter. This is by just sheer amazing play from Secret, avoiding all the ganks. Like, I still stand by what you said. Right now, the Bounty Hunter feels like the MVP. For all the warding vision he provided, when you can prevent any kills going the way of a Blink Slider and a Blink Puck, that's just incredible in itself.
Misery TP'd in. I don't think he was expecting the bear there, but it's not going to matter. He runs down EGM with auto attacks, and then they turn on the Bulldog. They've got the track going. Weeha there catches S4 as he blinks in and just gets subviscerated. Call down, penetrating Alliance here. Lota will be next. That's 4 with a buyback and an instant GG. They tap out. They exit the game as quickly as they can. Their bottoms are looking a little red, and it might even be the puck going down once more. Now, saved by the bell. That was a spanking.
Absolutely, Brew. I mean, Secret just showing some world-class play there. A team who doesn't crack under the pressure. They just sat back, knew exactly what